Let's play maybe an hour.
You got a second? Let me know when you're ready.
Okay.
I can't believe I wanted to shake his hand. I need a shower. Makes you wonder if being a treacherous two-timing coward is some sort of contagious disease, or if he was just born that way. At first, I liked what Graham was doing. The iconoclasts were gonna change Halcyon for the better. But then, we found out Graham was behind the slaughter of Amber Heights. How can anybody so morally bankrupt lead a movement to transform the colony?
Beats me, bro.
Yeah, maybe you're right. You'd never do something like that, would you? Slaughter a whole community of innocents? I know you've got your reasons for serving the board and all, but you wouldn't stoop as low as Graham. Let's get back to it. I need to put all this ugly business with Graham behind me.
Telling you the truth, for the right price, this character will do it. Okay. Radio Free Monarch. Fallbrook. You can get temporary and bonus for a skill.
Hungry? I'm famished myself. No rubbernecking. Make a buy or move on.
Henry Armour, yeah. $55,000. Wait, Liana Reed.
I offer high quality and low prices. Pick one for your purchase. If you bloody it, you buy it. Store policy.
Okay. UDL data been liberated from a corporate patrol. Okay.
Got nimble fingers, Captain.
Ah, there you are. Wait. Unlock. Okay, please enter password to confirm that you are an authorized Universal Defense Logistics Security Specialist. Please answer the following question. You are attending a company meeting at HHC headquarters in Byzantium, and while dissidents attack the building, what is your priority? You are pursuing one of our many UDL personal security mega outlets and enjoying our fine selection of employee compliance equipment. When you are approached by a stranger, he makes an off-handed comment that could be construed as an indirect insult to Chairman Rockwell. What do you do? Smile and walk away. Okay. You and your spouse have a healthy, loving relationship. But one day you discover that they have been reading unsanctioned stories to your children. What do you do? Okay. Hey, there's your boy.
Oh, Captain, you did it! My little boy is back, safe and sound! Tell the Captain how grateful we are, Tuck-Tuck.
Mama, I told you that I'm not staying. I just came back to talk to you about why I left. Then I'm going back to Amber Heights.
Oh, we'll get that silliness sorted out. You're safe here with me, and that's how it's going to stay. Isn't that right? What a sour thing to say. My little boy will always need me. I'm his mama, you know.
Mama, what I need is for you to listen to what I want for once. But that's between us. Now you promised the captain a reward, so settle up. Then you and me are gonna have a long talk.
Here, kind stranger. This is every bit I've scrimped and scraped for years to save. but it's more than worth it to have my Tuk-Tuk home safe again.
Oh, he's Ellie. Poor Tuk-Tuk.
Hey, Ellie, how's your head? Still spinning?
Felix, the secret to surviving a good night is a big breakfast. Wait, what are you yammering about?
I was just curious is all. You used to make a face whenever we talked, like you had a headache. But I guess you're feeling all right now.
Look, you're okay, but don't go rubbing it in, all right?
Do your part to support the local economy? Laws know we need it. What can I get you? All sales are final, unless you threaten me. I'm kidding. Don't threaten me.
I don't know. Oh shit. Buy back all of my this one. Adrino 8 Abandoned relay station, UDL lab.
Staying out of sight.
You
Someone else will clean this up, right?
Again? You want to buy something?
Hello there. A word, if I may be so bold.
Yeah, sure, why not?
Well now, here I thought those Mantisaurs had peacefully exited the premises. But you're a simpler explanation. Thanks for the assistance. Name's Weston. Every once in a while, I set up shop along these here roads. You find yourself in need of resupply, you come on by. Care to purchase a thing or two?
Level 26. Sell value. I'll take it. $2,000. I think I have this extra. Level 20. 17. I get another dead eye, it's yours. Small difference. Oh! Ooh. Well, that was stupid. Wait. Could go up there.
Okay. Love to get my hands on whatever did that.
We already killed on whatever did that. CNPL Borst Worst. It's the UDL. Abandoned relay station.
Mess with us.
Unfiltered air, rocks in my shoes, risky choke points, all the things I hate about mountains.
Step easy, boss. We got a real climb ahead of us.
Got
another fight in me.
Good job. Disgusting place.
The last of them.
Ultra. Yeah. This is level 20. Same shit. Oh shit, no way. If it's weakness against plasma, then yeah, I'll take it.
Hiking. Once you're up, you just gotta go.
This station's under the protection of the corporate compliance crew. You a marauder? Cause me and my sunshine, that's my gun if you were wondering. We don't take kindly to marauders.
Sure.
Reckon that sounded far too coherent for a marauder. That's good. Otherwise I'd have to kill you. You're clear. But I would caution you against pressing on ahead. This station's plumb crawling with marauders, you know? I take it you ain't met the other C3s. Me and Sunshine are doing exactly what we've been tasked with. You want more details? You ought to talk to my crew. They're guarding a small barracks to the southeast, by the edge of the mountain. See that path that runs underneath that giant archway? Follow it on down. There's a little station near the cliff. You'll find the rest of my crew there. There is nothing I'd enjoy more, but the C3s play it by the book. Usually. Go petition the boss man. Maybe you can convince him to alter my duties.
I will do exactly that.
How'd you get up here? Through the caves? Good answer. I wasn't looking forward to gut-shotting you. See, the thing is, I'm with the corporate compliance crew. C3, if you will. We're mercs. And our current contract mandates that we annihilate any creatures or persons that emerge from the tunnel.
Allow me to intervene. It's my job to mediate any conflicts of interest regarding C3 and third parties. All right. First things first. To make a decision in this dispute, I'm gonna need to know what your role in your organization is. A lean but efficient corporate structure. I'm impressed. Still, I gotta wonder, what are your intentions regarding Devil's Peak Station? That is why you've wandered out here, I presume.
Joy sent me to talk to you.
Well, that's all well and good, but the reason you've come is secondary to the arbitration at hand. Our guidelines allow us some leeway in identifying threats to our client. Your unorthodox profession makes me think we ought to remove you from the premises permanently.
You can certainly try.
The terms of our contract specifically targets marauders, iconoclasts, MSI operatives, and anyone deemed too hobo-like in appearance. As you don't appear to fit any of those categories, I'm afraid I can't quite make a call on you.
Don't we, as a standing policy, provide an alternative to termination via financial restitution? Addy, our chief financial officer, could confirm, but I'm betting if you're willing to compensate us for our lost time and productivity due to this arbitration, you could pass. I guess we might could. There's something I like about you. Can't put my finger on it, but I feel like I'd rather have you with us than against us. All right. Lance, unless you have a final point of contention to make, I'd say he's clear to go.
Nah. I'll sign the clearance form. Just, I must advise you to steer clear of Devil's Peak Station. It's teeming with marauders.
Anything else you need?
I met Joy by the station, was hoping to get you guys to do your job and take down the marauders.
Trying to say we didn't do our job? I'll have you know, our contract was to stop any marauders coming from the caves. Didn't say nothing about the ones taking the mountain path. We'll simply clear them out later, once we've got the go-ahead from Berthold. That's right, Berthold Fox is our boss man, founder, president, and CEO. Birdie went down into the caves on a hunt for marauders, give or take, 6 hours ago. He's a hands-on type. Likes to handle the tougher tasks himself. Although, he should have been back. Going on 6 hours now. I'd ask you to check the caves for him, but then we'd have to kill you when you crawl back out.
You're going to kill Berthold when he returns from the color caves too.
Space, no. The contract doesn't target C3s. How do we enforce it otherwise?
A mite cold-blooded, ain't he, Donald?
Done. Use this. Signal's locked to Birdie's tracker. Should lead you right to him. Or his body. Whatever you find. Bring him back to us, okay?
What if I kill the guy and take over his company? Could work. It could work. Ooh. Hell yeah. I'm gonna install some mods. Speedy range weapon barrel improves the weapons. No, I don't need that. Crit damage. Recoil aim sway. Critical. We go for critical. Plasma or shock? I would say magazine size. Weapon range plus 25%. Super scope 6 times. Range weapon minus 20%. So critical, magazine size. Maybe later si Chenyeo acid. I'm going to change this into, yeah. And as for this one, rate of fire. Magazine size. Oh. Range weapon spread. Yeah. Really? Tresla? Why not just silence or gonna stay? Radio Free Monarch. Stop moving, boy. Oh, shit! You might want to attack that guy.
Got this.
Okay. Looks like I will have to change my weapon loadout mods into maybe avoid. 16, 13, 17. Times critical melee. What? Oh, come on. That's what you get.
That assist was a violation of corporate law if I ever saw one. Since it was to my benefit, and we're largely in lawless lands, I'll look the other way. C3 owes you one, stranger. You haven't seen Constance, have you? Ah, there's her torso. And that'd be her legs over yonder, never mind. I'm Berthold. Means it's still holding the post then. Good. You might head on back. We can talk more there where it's safe. I'll be on my way once I've gathered up Constance's parts.
Donuts.
How'd you do that so fast?
Magic. Wow. Locking controls.
Thank you.
Hey, Mannequin Slayer. Glad you made it in one piece. After all, not everyone's so lucky. Meet my corporate compliance crew. Then check out our weapons locker inside. I reckon you'll find something you like. Then we call it even between us. You look like an idle body, and idlers get orders. We were hired to do so, why else? You did get the memo that we're mercenaries? Our client's a bit unorthodox, sure. He calls himself the Broker, and prefers the glow of a terminal to flesh and blood interaction. But I can't fault his work ethic. Our current gig's to stop, by means of lethal force, any creatures exiting the caverns, including but not limited to marauders, iconoclasts, and agents operating for the MSI. You drive a hard bargain, Mannequin Slayer. It don't make much financial sense for C3 to expend resources on any killing beyond the contract stipulations. As the marauders didn't enter from the caves, the requirements are murky. At the same time, we do want to keep our client alive until the payment's cleared. We recommended the client safeguard himself, so I don't expect that the main doors will be accessible. Find a way to open them, and we'll clear any hostiles on the inside. I'd best radio ahead for Joy and Hudson to prep for us. They'll be at the station entrance, ready with our finest auto mechanicals to assist you. C3s, prepare to move out.
There you are! Bossman said you'd be up this way.
You're living up in a tower on a place called Devil's Peak? Yep.
Fox radioed ahead. Said I'm to follow you. Provide whatever support you need. If those bastards start shooting, we'll join in. I gotta warn you, my girl Sunshine here is a tad trigger happy. Of course, me and her will follow your lead. Just wanted you to know we wouldn't begrudge you of any violent inclinations. You're A-okay, stranger. Hear that, Hudson? It's payday.
What?
What is that?
That's odd. That? Better take a look.
Processing.
Waste of complete ammo. What was that? System. Security patrol initiated.
Waste of company ammo.
Security threat eliminated. Unexpected. Now switching to garbage disposal mode.
Fighting ain't gonna get easier on the inside. Best hurry before the Marauders regroup. We'll keep watching.
You may not realize this, being as you're an outsider, but the blaring alarms indicate the station's on lockdown. Which means you can't ever get to me. So leave already.
Wanna fight you!
Make him regret it!
Score one for Felix!
Last of them.
whoever you are. Yes, yes, I can see you. Come here and talk to me. Face the intercom.
Show me how you did that.
Tell if you're brave or simply touched in the head. What in the galaxy are you doing sniffing around my station? Unless you are, in fact, trying to suicide by Marauder? You are? And to think I was just joking. Guess I'll leave you to it then. Kidding! I'm kidding! No one has a sense of humor these days. Or much of a backbone, for that matter. Look. The fact of the matter is this. By the hand of fate and my own cunning skill, I run this station. The Marauders may have other plans, and since my hired hands have clearly turned idle, it appears I have need of you. As my newest contractor, you may call me the Broker. Action. It's about time, I tell you. I'm up to my neck in marauders in here, which, by the by, they were supposed to prevent. I barricaded the broadcast center, but I can only hold out for so long. Clear the marauders out, and I'll pay you double the going rate. They destroy the transmission equipment, and I'll be out of business. The elevator and doors to the second floor are back online. Hurry before I have to lock them down again. Aside from the bits I'll be paying you, I trade in secrets, valuable ones, for my vocation. I'm sure you can come up with something you might like to ask me about in person once I'm safe. Too many, considering I hired a bunch of no-good mercs to keep them out in the first place. Already they've caused considerable damage to the station's property. If they take down the broadcast equipment, I'll be out of a job permanently.
Okay, I'm using my mouse and keyboard.
Thank you. Here we go.
Yeah.
Nice, Captain.
Now that was fun.
Never thought I'd be ecstatic at having the walls painted in blood, but seeing as it's not mine, I'd say this calls for a celebration. And you got me my money's worth out of the C3s. I ought to have simply dealt with you in the first place. Yes, I believe I do. This ought to square our debt. One hefty payment for a highly valued service rendered. But I admit, I do wonder why you ventured here at all. Allow me to pose my question in another manner. Why, in the Nebula, are you here? Allow me to assure you that I know absolutely nothing about any allegedly illegal broadcasts. Surely the board is aware of that. They must know I'd never involve myself in such despicable activities. There's utterly no reason to arrest anyone in this broadcast station, let alone me. In fact, you're doing me a favor by helping me disable any alleged such broadcasts, if they exist. You could do me another favor by mentioning my loyalty to the board in your report.
Ah, damn it, Hiram, you were so close. I was just starting to like you.
You've got a real creative definition of loyalty, and I mean that as a compliment.
I'm not sure whether to be touched or insulted by that. Look, you never met a man more willing to work with the board than me. I know we can come to an agreement, please.
Okay. You're laying it on the little thick. Yeah, intimidate. I think Sophia would be particularly interested to hear us. Yeah.
Sophia does? What sort of an amount are we intimating here? Never mind. The details are of no matter for now. I'm happy to help the board in any way I can, for so long as they consider me a friend. The station routes all communications across Monarch. Since the company towns were abandoned, the only local transmissions coming in are from Amber Heights or Stellar Bay. Graham and his iconoclasts believe anarchy is the way of life. Sanjar opposes it as he's taking strides to corporatize Stellar Bay. No, they're jamming the limited frequencies we have at our disposal. Nothing extraplanetary can get in or out until the frequency pollution thins out. The safest bet is to convince Graham and Sanjar to stop transmitting on their end. Do what you like. Just don't tell me about it after. I enjoy sleeping at night. I suppose it won't kill me to work under Sophia. I am on familiar terms with her from a, let's call it a past contract job. All that's left to do is cycle the antenna's receiver so I can input the needed adjustments, then I'll be in the board service. No further action required. Oh, don't be ridiculous.
We're resetting a broadcast tower, not filing taxes. There are no errands, spreadsheets, or rituals involved. It's simple, truly. I merely need you to waltz outside and throw the lever to cycle the power. I'll key in the numerical adjustments from in here. Someone has trust issues, though I can't hardly feign surprise. Yes, that is all. No, I am not mocking you. Much. Just step outside,
much.
Flip the switch, depart forever. Understood? Good. Marvelous. We're in agreement.
I'm starting to see why you don't get much company out here.
Terrific. I'll be here, waiting with bated breath. Give a shout if the panel electrocutes you.
This guy.
Teach me that.
Okay, be right back.
No one tells you how much of the job is waiting for action.
Hello? Ah, un dato lang. Para liya yun. Be right back, again!
We got time.
Okay. Sorry about that.
Devil's Peak Station is now fully affiliated with the board. I'm and ready for any and all propaganda purposes. Now I'll kindly thank you to get out of my tower. There's no need to assert your dominance. I doubt I could make you do anything you don't wish to. Look, I am well aware that at times I may have the tiniest iota of a prickly exterior, but I must admit I have grown rather fond of you. Take care out there.
Boss, are you seeing this?
Black holes! Did you see that? Look, there's not enough room in this tower for two sarcastic hullheads, so one of us has to knock it off. Right. I reckon we both know who that'll fall to. Oh well, a pity for the crew, but I can't see how it affects me.
Hiram? Can you hear me? Did you see that?
Architect, save me from swindlers and fools. Sanjar, what are you bloody doing on my channel? Did MSI or did MSI not cease broadcasting?
Yes, but...
Hiram. Hiram, are you there? Allow me to save you the trouble as I fling myself from this tower.
Ah, the good captain. The truth brings us together once more. Our salvation has come crashing through the stratosphere. We need only collect its weapons.
Are you mad? That's a UDL gunship. You'd probably shoot your own toes off.
Ah, I see you learned nothing while dealing with these buffoons.
We could use the gunship's armaments to defend Stellar Bay, but we need its targeting module.
Our message is so close to breaking free of this planet and spreading to the stars. Help us secure that module, and we will save our colony.
Listen, I don't care a single whit what you do, so long as you leave me out of it.
Which means, get off my void damn channel! I'm more than finished with you lot.
Return to Sophia. Means 28 and then 30. This one and this. The illegal broadcast on Monarch have been put to an end. Travel back to Byzantium and report your success to Sophia. The distress call must have originated. But before we do that, 168. Cascadia, darn like.
Do your part to support the local economy? What can... If you don't see it, I don't...
Yeah! Warmed up now.